I was hoping he'd be her size. Get low. You tell him. I gotta send this to my friend Jill. You tell him. So funny. They're like buddies.
Do you?
I got something good to rub on. Make me smell real good.
Check this out, guys. I'm not gonna be able to put this on the main channel because it'll demonetize it. I'm trying to learn how to use this handheld, and I went over to the FM, the radio stations, and I was scanning through it. Come on, Beagle. Let's dance. Let's dance. Come on, Beagle. Let's dance. Hey, party pooper. I keep finding hats. It's the second one I've found.
Give me a little different view of the waves here if it helps.
So I'm going to say this too. I'll probably put this little snippet, you know, in a behind the scenes or something, you know, because it sounds like I'm being confrontational or with somebody, but some, you know, people, but I'm not. But I, you know, I often get on like some forums, you know, on Facebook and online, where people are often, like with my Vagabond, for example, there's some people who think I have it overpowered. You know, it's like, those boats are designed for a 9.9 or a 15 horse. And it's like, yeah, you can move around a Vagabond, for example, or a Nomad, or even this boat, you know, with a 9.9 or a 15 in ideal conditions when there's no, when you're not beating against the wind or any current or, you know, like we're doing right now. But if I had a 9.9 or a 15 in the back of this boat, or let's just say I was in the Vagabond, I wouldn't be going anywhere. I'd have to go hide from this, you know, which I would. You know, there's islands all over the place. There's some right over there with some probably enough depth to get behind, and we just wait for the wind to go to die down. So, you know, it's I'm glad I got a 60 horse in the back. You know, a 40, a 50, a 60 will get the job done on a boat like this and on a boat like the Vagabond or a Nomad. It could be done. I mean, people have floated these rivers, you know, with no power at all. I've said it before, the Hubbards did, you know, wrote their book to the shanty boat. And they floated these rivers for years and years, and there wasn't even any propulsion back then when they were doing it. So, that was a big one. So yeah, of course, anything can be done, you know. But in this day and age where it's pretty easy to just get a, you know, a mid-size horsepower four-stroke, then why not do it? Here's my little workhorse back here, just unfazed. I'm at like, I don't know, 2,000 RPMs, maybe 2,200 RPMs. I kicked it up a little bit because we're going into the wind. So just make life easy on yourself, guys. That's my little rant for the day. Let me see if I can show this to you while I'm cowering in the cabin with the doors closed, because we're going right into the wind and it's kind of chilly. So this train, you can see it way back there, probably a couple miles, and then here it is passing us. It's the same train. It just shows what a good idea trains are for moving stuff around. Beagle needs to go to shore, and we just keep passing by these pretty decent spots, but I think this one's gonna work. It's got a sandy beach on the backside there. Stay tuned, guys. All right, did it. What are you doing? This is what she starts doing when I'm cooking. She just needs to get off the boat so bad, and then she starts smelling food, and she'll just sit here and stare. She smells meat. I thought you wanted off the boat so bad. You goofball. You're goofy. Oh, and you're even in the water a little bit. Well, come on. Well, come on. Let's go. Lazy animal. I don't know, it probably looks gross, but I've got some steak, a couple eggs, potatoes, and condiments. Free condiments. Anytime you're at a store, grab some condiments. I've been seeing these white signs all over islands, mostly. Any place there's like a beach or something, they have them. And I've been wondering what they say, because it's obviously small print. I'm going to read the gist of it. It's actually not as restrictive as I would have guessed. So camping, you can basically camp here for 14 days in a row, and then you got to move on. Campfires are allowed. You just got to use driftwood and stuff that's already here. Behavior, no loud noise is what it pretty much amounts to. Alcohol, it's allowed. But it says if you're under the influence of alcohol, just a typical, you know, just common sense stuff. And remove all your, you know, garbage when you're done. Sanitation, take your trash and refuse out. Let's see, what else? Dogs are not allowed to disturb the wildlife, but they are allowed. Firearms may not be discharged in the refuge except by licensed hunters and trappers. Fireworks, no go on fireworks. So anyways, yeah, you know, there's all these spots here. If you were just coming through in a canoe or a kayak or something, you could just set up a tent and stay here for 2 weeks, no problem. All right, guys, I just had a second cup of coffee today. So my brain is just... I was just thinking this. I'm going to try to articulate it. If you're watching this, then I decided that it was articulated enough to post it. So wait for this train to finish passing by. If you do this trip, you better like trains. Or just do what Hobo Shoestring or Shoestring Hobo, or he's got a great channel. Do what he does. He just rides the rails all over the country. I might do that someday. You never know. Okay, so here's my thought. There's this movie. It's called Dark City. It's a sci-fi kind of dystopian type movie that came out right before The Matrix did. Some people even say it might be like a prelude or a precursor to The Matrix. It's really good, and it's deep. And I was just thinking about that for some reason, and I started to think about how I'm out here today. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's t-shirt weather. It's probably 68 degrees, and it's gorgeous, and there's the fall colors. And I started thinking that, you know, I'm kind of a conspiracy-minded person, forgive me, but I'm a conspiracy factualist, actually. And I was just thinking, you know, there's these forces at work, you know, we don't have to name them, you know, we can, but we don't need to, that are basically trying to keep us all the time from doing stuff like this, because this is the real world. It's the real world. It's where we're meant to be. And yet so few people are out here doing it. And I'm not trying to project my own kind of values, like this is what I like to do and you should like to do this too. It doesn't really matter. You could want to ride your motorcycle around. You could want to ride your bicycle around. You could just getting out in the real world. There, if you have your mindset in the right way, you can see how it's very plausible that they, which we could talk about some other time, don't want us to be out here. They want us stuck in screens. They want us stuck inside. They want us working, slaving, barely getting by, unhappy, unhealthy, depressed. And it's hard, maybe even impossible, to be depressed out here. At least it is for me. So, anyways, take with that what you will. I gotta go steer the boat. Why have I never heard of this town? I can't believe it. It's so my kind of town to explore. You guys are gonna love this. Hopefully we can look at this. It's right next to a restaurant called Little Switzerland. All these bricks say Purington. Purington bricks.